Hello everyone. Today I am here to start your chapter 4, Working with Styles and Objects. Earlier, Bindu ma'am has taught you about the other MS features like replacing, finding the text, printing the document, or indentation, rest all. But today I'll start chapter 4 with more features which are in this chapter. Let's understand these one by one. Here is chapter 4, Working with Styles and Objects. Let's start. Style. A style is a set of text formatting characteristics such as font size, color, and alignment, or any other formatting feature. For example, as a user, if you have written in MS Word something, and you select heading 1. If you can see my pointer, the figure is given below. There are by default styles are available in MS Word. This one is the heading 1. So if you have written something in MS Word and select this heading 1, so whatever the size and text and color and formatting feature is applied in this style, all will be applied to your text. Let me show you practically within MS Word. If you see, I have written something by default, any text here. Now it is a normal style. But if I select here, select the text and go to this heading 1, you will see some changes here. Automatically the text color is blue, the size is 20 if you see here. And it is Arial. Now suppose I want to change the style. You can change the styles, predefined styles also. Like if I select heading 2, now it is changed into 2. Its size is 13 and it is in the calibri. So if you select heading 3, it is more different. So these are the default heading 3, heading 2, default styles. Now you can change it. Now suppose heading 2, right click, modify, now select size 15, 14 suppose, change the, make it any other calibri, and you want the text color, here you can change it to this and open. Suppose italic also. So this way you click on OK. So it is changed. If you write, suppose, now I click back it to the normal, and if I select heading 2, now it is coming into this style which we have changed. So this way by default styles are available. You can change into yours by doing right click, modify, and then do it, or either you can do it remove or you can rename it also. So this way you can work with styles. So the style can be adjusted at any time, which means if you have several heading 1, so you can modify the style, changes the look of your headings automatically. This way you can change. Types of styles. Now there are two basic types of styles in Microsoft Word. The first one is paragraph styles, the other is character styles. Paragraph styles determine the appearance of the text in terms of the whole paragraph, which we just now did. We applied the paragraph styles, right? Paragraph styles format the following attributes: indents, spacing, line and page breaks, everything. So character style determine the appearance of text in terms of individual characters. They format the following attributes: size, color, bold, italic, underline, anything else. So all there are two things, paragraph and character. As if you can go through your book, also a style is a predefined combination of formatting feature, font style, color, changing the size of the text that is applied to the selected text in a document to change its appearance. And there are two types: character style and paragraph style. A character style affects the selected text within a paragraph, and paragraph style controls all aspects of the paragraph appearance. So till here we have finished this styles. Next is applying built-in styles. How to apply it, which I have already shown you practically in MS Word, like this. Go, select and click. So when I selected particular text and clicking on the heading 3, it is changing into that and other is in the default. If I don't select, I click on this one or this one, that is applying to the entire paragraph. So you have to see in which you want to apply. So this way you can apply. As you can see, click the styles dialog box launcher button in the styles group on the home tab. It displays the list of inbuilt styles and choose the style heading 1. Or you can choose like from here, if you see the figure. Or by clicking on this launcher button, you will see all other predefined styles available. You can select any one from here. So this way you can apply built-in styles, or I have shown you the practically also. That also you can change. Now creating a new style. I have shown you how to modify the existing one which is already there. We have changed the properties like color, like size, all other things we have changed. But how to create a new style? Let's understand. Now see, if I click on this launcher button, as I have available styles, you can create some more new by clicking on this drop down, more drop down arrow. There is an option create a style. You can give a name here like ST1, right? Now okay, there is ST1. Now you can change its properties by clicking on modify. We will mention it as Algerian, size is 40, color would be not this one, we'll make it yellow. So okay, now if you can see, it is ST1 is added here. It was not earlier present, now it is present here. Now if I click and select, you see it is changed into yellow color and Algerian. See here. So all this can be done in this way. As here, as I have shown you here by clicking on this more button, you can see the PowerPoint also. I have shown each and everything very nicely so that you can understand where the option is. This one was the launcher button and this is the more button. Okay, so now we have learned how to create a new style. As you can see here also, there is a new creating a new style button here, and this way you can change here and click OK and then go ahead. This way it will be shown on your styles bar. Next one is inserting word art. Before word art, we have learned, let's recall what we have learned now. We have learned what is style, what are the types of styles, how to apply inbuilt styles on your document, how to create new style, and how to change the properties of the default style which is already there, how to change its properties, how to create new, how to apply, what are the types, and what is style. So now we will learn how to insert word art. Let's understand now. Inserting word art. click the word art button in the insert group on your insert tab. Click the word art style that most closely resembles what you want to create and then click OK. Like if you see the figure here where my pointer is, when you click on the word art button in the insert tab, this figure will appear. There are lots of word art designs where whichever you will choose and then click OK. It will come now in this figure where my pointer is. Like there is a word written warm weekly. By default it will be written word art. By cutting it you can select warm weekly, or you can write your name also. When you have written something here, then press OK. After clicking on the OK button, your actually word will appear in this way, which is given in the figure where my pointer is. By default, suppose you have selected this design from this word art box. You have written some text like warm weekly. When you press OK, it will appear warm weekly. Let's recall once more. Here, out of this box, whatever the design you will choose, like this one I have chosen, and you click type something here, press OK, and then this text will appear in this form here. So this way you can apply word art. Let's understand it practically. But I have MS Office 2010 version. You are studying 2007, but I have 2013, sorry. So it will not be same option as you have seen in your presentation, but let me show you once how to do. Insert tab, the word art button, it is little different. When I selected suppose this design, so it is coming in the same way. You will also get the same thing when you write warm weekly. It will come in the same style which you have chosen here in the word art. So once you have written, you can see here are more options. You can change it, or you want to change the entire one, you have to select, or you want to change this way, you can change. Now here you can see the reflections. If you notice here, when I take my pointer, see the text glow like this. Can you observe the changes? So wherever you click, it will be applied, as you can see here, right? Same way you can fill it styles. You can fill the text box, right? So all these things are there. You can change it from here also, or you can change like this one. So this way you can do. In your 2007 version, it is little different. That is more easy from here. So if you go with this presentation, you will get in this way, like I have taught you. Now we will study till here. Now we'll continue with the next video, but till that point, whatever we have studied today, you do practice at home on your computer, and it is your homework. Apply word art designs to these words. One design to birthday bash, other designs to peace, and other third design to sunshine. You can choose your own word art design, but all these three should be different and in the bigger boxes. You can resize also all those boxes. Like here, if I show you, by taking here to this thing. So this way also you can do in your 2007 version. So this, it is your homework to apply word art to these words. It's your homework. to apply word art. Please do practice so that you will be able to do it easily whenever we'll do the practical in school or in test. Thank you. Till then, have a nice day. Have a safe day. Thank you.